Come on now, shake it up, baby. Yeah, the Isley Brothers from 62. And yes, twist and shout. It was easy back then. Try doing it now. No, don't do that. Something's liable to break. 2 minutes after nine, actually 1 minute after nine, from KFXM LP Lancaster, the heart and soul of rock and roll, along with K237CG in your current at 95.3.
KFXM weather.
Oh, they just came right in there and sang their song. Sunny and hot, high of 96. Okay, southwest winds to 15 with gusts as high as 25. Tonight clear, low around 65, and west winds to 25 miles an hour. Going to be hotter than 700 hells, I told you. Tomorrow, it's going to be right there on the borderline. We might see 100 tomorrow. Triple digits tomorrow. Yep, sunny and hot with a high around 100. And the winds continue to 25 miles an hour. Currently, right now, right here on our show tonight, for all you youngsters out there, what is the temperature? Did you shake the thermometer down? Well, shake it down. Come on, we're on the radio. I'm pressed for time like an Egyptian mummy. Okay, what do we got here? We got what? We got, what is it? I can't read it. I don't know. Oh, I got my glasses on backwards. Yeah, do you remember what happened with the Hubble telescope years ago? Yeah, somehow some operator, some guy with real thick glasses, didn't see what he was supposed to see, and he reversed the Hubble telescope. It was looking at the sun, and, you know, they're making everything big. Well, when you turn it around, you know, he supposedly burned a hole right through China, and that's them getting even with us with the pandemic, yeah. So anyway, where were we? Oh, yes, it's 79 degrees at KFXM Channel 98.
The death is a severe loss to me personally and to the community at large, which he served so well and faithfully. I ask you all to join me in 1 minute silence in contemplation of this fine, devoted public servant.
Funeral. Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to
Chris Compton.
So you got to go downtown, that's right, and there's strict rules you have to obey when you go downtown, you know.
I want it strictly understood that there'll be no undue shouting or cheering.
Yeah?
Or drunken talk.
Okay, you have to go to Palmdale to get that. All right. 7 after 9 o'clock on a Saturday morning as we get things whipping in the wind. With Three Dog Night, the show must go on, yes. That's the first time I ever saw anything like that. The show must go on. It was a, it was one of these gals like Gypsy Rose Lee, yeah. That was came out. The curtain opened up, and she was out there and doing dancing and everything. And she started to remove her clothing, and as soon as she started doing that. Yep, the audience yelled, put it back, yeah, yeah, it was something else. And then they got the hook and pulled her off the stage, and she was never seen ever again until August 20th of 1966. Yep, she was selling pencils in the parking lot of the Theater in the Round in West Covina, California.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so do I. Get out. Gonna play this for my friend Chuck over at Expert Tree Servers. Yeah.
Everybody's doing a brand new dance now.
Jump back, do the locomotion. Played that for old Chuck over there. He's out of his tree this morning. Yeah, he's walking around on the ground and everything. I called him a long time ago about a sick tree. How did you know it was a sick tree, Chris? Well, I walked by the tree and it threw up on me. I guess maybe, yeah, it was a sick tree. Yeah. Morning, and of course, Bobby Goldsboro. It sounds like a small village in the hills of Pennsylvania, don't it? Up in the, what do they call those mountains there? The Adirondacks? Is that to Pennsylvania? Anyway, the it's upstate Pennsylvania. 15 and a half after 9 from Channel 98 KFXM. Time now for a visit from the Story Lady.
It's time now for another visit with the Story Lady.
Hello, children. Today we're going to hear the story I call The Lost Continent of Atlantis. Once upon a time, a very long, long time ago, somewhere in the Atlantic Ocean west of Gibraltar, there was a mighty kingdom known as Atlantis. Atlantis was very rich and very powerful and was blessed with every beauty that any land could ever have. But the citizens of Atlantis were very, very wicked. Each day they spent more and more of their time cheating and stealing from their fellow man. Soon Atlantis was known far and wide as the most evil and immoral of all lands, and was such a disgrace that all the gods on Mount Olympus decided that Atlantis could no longer be a blot on the face of the earth. And so they sent a great disaster, and the entire kingdom of Atlantis sank to the bottom of the sea, severely injuring Richard Basehart, Lloyd Bridges, and a couple of herring.
Thank you, Story Lady. Be listening next time, boys and girls, when the Story Lady will tell you how to get into a pay toilet without a dime.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to
Chris Compton.
KFXM 98.3, Lonnie Mack and Memphis. Yeah, it's the instrumental version of Chuck Berry's classic. Yep, operator, give me Memphis, Tennessee. 21 after 9, you get that? 21 minutes after 9 o'clock at Channel 98 KFXM. What's going on here, huh? What's happening? Oh, okay. We have a public service announcement from some small police department in the Midwest. Okay, put it through in here. Push the red button there. Thank you.
This is Police Sergeant Edward O'Reilly. The parents of Mary Harkness have asked the police to search for their daughter, who has been missing since 6 p.m. yesterday. She was last seen wearing a blue sweater, gray skirt. Mary is 99 years old and weighs 9 pounds.
Wonderful! KFXM!
Pride of SLC, Salt Lake City, and that's right, the Great Salt. Ever been to the Great Salt Lake? Yep. Yeah, you can't sink in that lake. Yeah, that's why a lot of people that weigh 300 pounds plus swim in there. They just bob around, you know. One guy got in at Salt Lake City and wound up somewhere in the mountains of Nevada. It was something else, but he enjoyed the ride, yeah.
I was told to mop along the dusty when a marker road.
I know some place you haven't been.
I've been everywhere.
He's been everywhere. Hank Snow, his real name, Clarence. Yeah, could you say this two-fisted, hairy-chested, bulldog-chasing, telephone pole-climbing, cowboy kind of guy, you know. What's your name, cowboy? Well, my name is Clarence. Where are you from, Clarence?
I'm from Brooklyn, New York.
Okay. there used to be some people in Brooklyn that were named Clarence, some guys, but they've been cleaned out a long time ago by the gangs. The 10th Street Gang, yeah. Yeah, 28 minutes after 9 o'clock from Channel 98 KFXM. What's that?
Ding-a-dong-ding.
Of course I could sing. Are you kidding? Yeah, that's right. But you know, there are no singers in the Mafia. You ever notice that? Not anymore. No. No singers. Well, if there ever were, they're not there anymore. Yeah, they go. What's that, sir?
Where were you during the week?
The laughing and the tears.
Huh? What?
The cruel eyes studying you.
Oh, you were at traffic court, huh? Okay, and you got the transcript of what the judge said? Would you play the transcript, please? Thank you.
Now, there's no need for that.
Okay.
I know exactly what he'll tell you. Lies.
Oh, really?
No different from any other officer in the wardroom. They were all disloyal.
Okay, they were. Okay.
I tried to run the ship properly with the book, but they fought me at every turn. If the crew wanted to walk around with their shirt tails hanging out, that's all right. Let them. Take the tow line. Defective equipment.
Huh?
No
what?
More, no less.
This is traffic court, is this?
They encouraged the crew to go around scoffing at me and spreading wild rumors about scheming in circles and then old Yellowstain. I was to blame for Lieutenant Merrick's incompetence.
You
and
were,
seamanship.
Yes. You know,
Lieutenant Merrick was the perfect officer.
LAPD, you know. Well, wow.
Ah, but the strawberries.
What?
That's where I had them. They laughed at me and made jokes.
You put them all over your head.
Beyond the shadow of a doubt and with geometric logic, that a duplicate key to the wardrobe icebox did exist. And I'd have produced that key if they hadn't pulled the cane out of action.
Yeah, they did.
I know now they were only trying to protect some fellow officer. And
yeah, it's the police every time. Yeah, you know, it's just... Mr. Bojangles. Was there a Mrs. Bojangles? I don't know. And that was quite a saga, wasn't it? Yeah.
Same old story.
Yeah.
Boy finds girl, boy
right.
loses girl,
uh-huh.
girl finds boy.
Uh-huh.
Boy forgets girl, boy remembers girl.
Yep.
And girl dies in a tragic blimp accident.
Tragic.
The Orange Bowl on New Year's Day.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful trip. The movie star, the professor and Mary Ann, here on Gilligan's Island.
Wonderful! KFXM!
Yellow River and Christy, Channel 98 KFXM, 21 before 10 o'clock already. Wow, boy, the time is flying by when you're having fun. Boy, I tell you, I'm having more fun than anyone ever imagined having fun. Just being here with you is great. I appreciate that. And hopefully our stream is improved. Boy, we spent a lot of time working on it. There was a lot of interruptions if you're listening on the internet. Lots of interruptions since a couple of weeks ago when the Frontier phone company went slightly funny in the head, as they said in the movie Dr. Strangelove, and they threw all kinds of pieces of equipment at it and everything. I think they might have it down to a science now. So it should be okay. It shouldn't drop out all the time and do all kinds of strange things. But if it does, just send me $100 and I'll send you a self-addressed stamped envelope. No, not that one, not that one, not that one. This one. Yep. Yeah, you can't listen to that song and not visualize in your mind Benny Hill. Yep. He perpetuated vaudeville, I think, on his show. Yep. From England, you know. And everybody thought he was a jolly time guy, and everybody envisioned him going to cocktail parties and, you know. And he was a very, very odd guy, very, very humble. He'd leave the studio and walk to his cold water flat, not far from where they made the Benny Hill show. And sit there in the room watching black and white television with a single light in the ceiling. He was really, I guess he was, depression strikes hard. But he was, ever hear that song, The Funny Little Clown? Do we have that? Just a minute, hang on a second, don't go away. I'm sure I came across it this morning. And there it is. Okay, I want to play this. I'm going to play this for Benny Hill. Yeah, I'm going to play this for Benny Hill because this describes him down to a very, very small feature and everything, and it's kind of sad, really. You know, he's always smiling for everybody and making him laugh and all that, and inside, you know, he's just crying his eyes out and just screaming for help, a silent scream. That's what people like Benny Hill put out. Here it is. Bobby Goldsboro and See the Funny Little Clown.
I'm that funny little clown.
Kind of a sad song, huh? Bobby Goldsboro.
See the funny little clown.
See the funny little clown. Benny Hill, yeah, and he'd eat, you know, he'd eat a cold sardine sandwich on two-day-old bread and everything, and put his little outfit on and go back to tape another show tomorrow with all the fun and the women and everything else. Yeah.
Somebody ought to cover him up.
They should. They really should. What have we got there? Did somebody slip something in here that we shouldn't be slipped in? Yeah, they did. Get it out of here.
If you're fond of sand dunes and salty air, come.
Oh, yeah, Patty Page, the singing rage. Okay. Old Cape Cod. Ah, yes, I knew it well. Yes, Katie Tootie. Anyway, 10 before 10 o'clock at Channel 98. Yeah, they have a lot of fish at Cape Cod. I can't eat fish. My mother ruined me on fish. That's all there is to it. She made codfish. Oh, she did. She did. You want to know how she made it? She would go and buy a codfish at the fish market and take it home in a paper wrapper and then rinse it off in the sink. But if you're offended real easy or if you're weak-kneed, just turn the other way for a minute. She'd take a knife and pop the eyeballs out of the thing over the sink, you know. No, really. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, sir. We didn't mean to use it like a pea shooter. Would you pick up that eye and throw the eye? The eye in the sky. There you go. Anyway, so she would pop the eyeballs out of the thing, and then she'd slit it down the middle for whatever reason, and just throw it into a pot of boiling salt water, and threw in about 4 or 5 carrots, and boiled it until the fish turned kind of a white rice-looking color. And then she'd fish it out and slice it up and put it in the plate and serve it. My father ate it. He knew if he didn't eat it, boy, was he going to be in trouble. But I couldn't handle it. I'm just terribly sorry. I couldn't handle it. It was that bad. It was horrible. Oh, jeez. Oh, my goodness. Holy, yeah, it was hard. Yeah. Wow. I could never eat fish after that. Never, 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 never. Wow. All the cats would follow me home. I'd stuff it in my pocket. Yeah, well, that was a good fish, Mom. Yeah. Whew. I can still smell it. Permeating half of Brooklyn. Yeah. Lucille, Everlove, and Everly Brothers. Don and Phil. Okay. 6 before 10 o'clock. Channel 98 KFXM. Let's look at that weather again because it says so. Yeah, it says right here, by order of the program director, you must look at the weather more than once an hour. Okay, 82 right now at the KFXM Time and Temp Tower, and looking for a high of 96 today. Going to be hotter than 700 hells, yeah? Going to be enough to put a bow of sweat right on your brow. And wow, 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 it's on your brow, brow, brow. Yeah, they got to make a song out of that, huh? Yep. Okay. Anyway, and tonight, it becomes clear. It becomes clear, my dear Watson. Yes, 65 for the low and winds to 25 miles an hour. Tomorrow, clear and sunny and hot with a high of about 100. It could be 100 tomorrow. Yeah, 100. And let's see if we could. Can we dial in the Death Valley weather? Because you know what? This has not been a real hot summer in Death Valley. No, it sure hasn't. So anyway, let's take a look at Death Valley. Yes, there's Ronald Reagan, the ghost of Ronald Reagan riding through Death Valley, telling stories about the old prospectors. Right now in Death Valley, it's 95. And they're looking for a high today in Death Valley of 115. Tomorrow, it looks like 118 in Death Valley. And Monday, 118. And then it starts cooling on Tuesday down to 117. And then Wednesday, back up again to 118. Thursday looks like 117. And Friday, it's going to really cook. 119 degrees on Friday in Death Valley, California.
Oh, well, everybody's heard about the bird.
Surfing bird. And the Trash Men on the Garrett record label. They're from Minneapolis. And I think, if memory serves me correctly, weren't they on one of the national shows like Dick Clark's Where the Action Is or something like that? And weren't they, they had a garbage truck. And they were all in various places on the garbage truck, all singing along like it was really great. And boy, did it smell, though. It really stunk. And yeah,
I could smell it in the car. It stink.
Yeah.
Is it me?
No, it was the Trash Men. One of my all-time favorites. Oh, my goodness. And Walter Brennan doing the narration on that. Wow. You know, when I was a kid growing up, I didn't have a very big family. It was an old family. Yep, like, you know, my mom and my dad were just twice as old as people that normally have children and all that. And it was like that. And I kind of, as my family passed away, like every other day we were getting a notice in the mail as so and so died and all that. And it was really, really hard to grasp. But I kind of adopted Walter Brennan as my grandpa. I really did when I was a kid. And I actually had the privilege of talking to Walter Brennan Jr. I guess his name was Andrew, and he changed it to his father's name. It was complicated. He lives in Camarillo. Real nice guy. One of the nicest people I've ever met. And just a super guy. And he calls himself Walter Brennan. And he was my granddad. I adopted him, and I watched The Real McCoys. I never missed a minute of that. And when they came out on a DVD, wow. Boy, I was standing in line with money in hand to take care of that. Anyway, where were we? 3 minutes after 10 o'clock at KFXM LP Lancaster, the heart and soul of rock and roll, along with K237CG in Yokern at 95.3. It's our Saturday go-around time. Yep.
I never thought I'd cut a record by myself. Instead of
wildly. Laugh at Me by Sonny without Cher. Yep, that's when they started arguing in public. Remember that? Yep. And she, on the Sonny and Cher Good Time Hour, remember that she was always putting him down and down, down, down. And I don't even think she even showed up when he was running for the mayor's job in Palm Springs. He was the mayor at one time, I think. Yep. It had a real neat restaurant down there at one time, too. Yep. Sonny Bono, KFXM, Channel 98. You know, Sonny and Cher, before they became Sonny and Cher, they had a different name for their duet, and they could not sell one record, not even to a family member. Yeah, they were known as Caesar and Cleopatra. And The wise men and wise men in music industry, Kimisabi, they told him, you call yourself Sonny and Cher. It's just a Caesar and Cleopatra. Haven't we had enough of Cleopatra in the movies? Yeah, we've seen Elizabeth Taylor too many times, you know. And so they changed your name to Sonny and Cher, and boom, the rest is history. That's right, 7 after 10 o'clock right now, Channel 98. I thought I'd play another one. I just can't. I love this duet. Yep. Sonny and Cher on KFXM. But you're mine. What about my mind? Fool's gold mine.
When people say you're not my kind, and I know you love me, baby.
What a escape.
What
is fake from the thing there? From the terrarium? Oh, my goodness. Oh, wow. We got a giant lizard. He escaped from the terrarium here at KFXM, and he's, you know, scaring everybody away and all that. You want to help get him, will you? That I don't like lizards running around here like that. That thing looked like it belonged in one of those Journey to the Center of the Earth movies. Remember where they took a picture of a small lizard and blew it up to the size of the movie screen? You remember that, don't you? And it would sit there with its tongue going in slow motion. Yeah, you remember that, don't you? Yeah. How many times did they do that? And the kids, including myself, bought into it. You know, oh, look at that. I'm going to hide under the seat. Okay, all right.
Hey, lizard.
Here, lizard, go away, will you? My goodness. Is that it over there, ma'am? There's a lizard crawling up. Yeah, you better turn around and whisk it off.
Let me take you down.
Come back. You're not finished, guys. Come on. That's, boy, it doesn't walk around in circles. Oh, the white stripes on the pavement on Abbey Road kind of screwed him up a little bit. Yeah. Strawberries. That was the kind of a turning point in the career of the Beatles, in my opinion. Yeah, they went from I Love You, You Love Me, I Want to Hold Your Hand Because Your Breath Is Too Much, and that sort of thing. But yeah. But then when the psychedelic era hit with, the psychedelic music and the Beatles and all, wow, unbelievable. That's right, 15 after 10 o'clock right now at Channel 98 KFXM.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to
Chris Compton.
Come on, let's turkey trot. Up and down and up and down. There's the little Eva from Channel 98 KFXM.
I'll make it fast, will you? I'm in a hurry.
Well, yeah, but sir, your pants are down around your ankles. You better pick them up first. Yep. Oh, my goodness. Whoa.
Looks like you could use a new radiator hose.
Yeah, we could use several of them, sir. I was Kaiser Bill's Batman. Here's Whistling Jack Smith. Love that name.